What's up, guys? Chris Labash. Just taking out the Outcast for a little bit of a little run. Does this sound like one of my planetaries, or something going on in the one of the diffs? I think it might be the center. You kind of hear it. Clicking. I don't know if it needs to just let it run. I did tighten up the I went through the diff, so I did tighten up the, put another shim in the front. It's definitely getting louder. Guess we're never gonna know until it. Yeah, it sounds like the front. Found something out. Or is it in the rear? All four are still in the rear. Center diff. So, as you can guys see, definitely in the center here. You see the bars in the way on this side. Let me go over here. You see the amp. There we go. So, broke one of the planetaries in the center. I thought it was in the front when I took it apart, but I shinned that up. I guess I should have been focusing on the center, but the front, yeah, that feels funky too, guys. Definitely have to get it in and take her apart. It's not the back, it's not the front. It's definitely the center, so we'll go in and if you guys want to see a video about that, here. Yeah, front spinning still, no front top. No front tires are pulling, so definitely a center diff problem here. I just went through them all. Maybe I don't believe I did something wrong, but yeah, that'll be next video. Gonna have to see what I did. Heard it clicking as soon as we came out, but you gotta drive it a little bit to make sure you can figure out what diff it's gonna be. Oh, did all the yard today, all the leaves out. Pretty, such a nice day. Ooh, click, 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 click. Right on the front. Now we have to take apart the outcast. And as you saw, I loosened up the front shocks there, but I was definitely riding a little bit too low. So we're on 6S per hour. This baby is totally built, but I have never replaced any part on the diff, because any diffs, haven't done one planetary pinion or ring on any of the diffs, because as soon as I went through them, I shimmed them all. And everybody knows about these diffs and shimming them, but it's super easy at least to get to the center diff. I mean, we could probably get there pretty much in a few minutes. We'll take it apart now. Let me get it up onto the desk and get going. What's up, guys? Chris Labash, welcome back to the channel. We're gonna get started on tearing apart the 6S outcast. Obviously, I know it's the center diff. I'll show you how to shim it up, because it's gonna be all shimmed up when we take it apart. So if you want to check that out, and you can shim all your diffs this way. So, yeah, stay tuned. We'll take it apart quickly, because should be simple. We have the easy mount V4 version. So, was a V2 version, but now it's a V4 version. Made it, put all the upgrades as the version 4 has. So, all right, we'll check that out. Stay tuned. Okay. Did not even need to take that screw out. Totally forgot about that. Because I forgot about the two aluminum pieces. So, let's see if we could just roll out the center without moving the motor. Sometimes, if you have enough play in the drive shafts, you can roll. If you can get one drive shaft out, you're good. What does it look like? You're gonna get one. Try the back one since it's shorter. Front one out. The front one's out. We should be able to slide the back up and out. Like so. Okay, so what do we got here? Everything feels okay this way. But we had to have broken a planetary in the center diff. So, okay, let's move now. Move you guys back. I'm moving the truck over. And we'll take a look at this diff here. The fluid is gray. It's usually a sign of metal. And it might not be a planetary, it might just be a. This kind of looks worn down here. Instead of ruining my nice microfiber, let's just put this on a regular rag here.
Thank you for ruining my life. thank you for leaving me in this fucking mess. I hate you so much I can barely breathe.
No, it could be one of the sun. The sun years.
Because that's where you left me and Casey.
Yeah, this bottom sun ring gear is definitely flattened. And we'll see if there's a shim underneath it. Should be. Mugen shim underneath.
Okay, gotta go again. Make something clear.
Oh, he said changing the mood of the room.
Seriously?
Yes.
I won't have sex.
Okay.
Well, I just want to make that clear.
I know. I guess.
The shim is intact. Say it's the current. Oh yeah, here's our victim. This is our problem here. We're almost down to, you know, pretty round. You know, both sides is just want to take the gasket off without ruining it. Alright. Yeah, we need to change these two gears. Definitely our issue. Your pin lines up with your out drive cup. If you're ever wondering. So you're pretty tight on there with these shims. So you just go from the side inside of the gear, and these pins line up with your outdrive cups. If you're ever curious about where the pin is, it's a straight line. So, yep, and here's our Mugen shim. I don't know if you guys could see that. Shim on there. Nope. Looks like we'll be rebuilding the center diff. Also, when you take off your out drives on the differentials for these, always keep your bearing on. Can't tell you how many times I've put these together and just forgotten to do this. So when I take them apart, I just set them aside.
Good, you're not dead.
With the
break in, call the police. It's a relief.
With the bearing on the cup.
You know, you just could have said you wanted to come over.
What's the fun in that?
Alright, so that's how quickly you could take apart the center diff on a Outcast with the new setup, the V4 version.
You know,
I think that took me about 10 minutes.
You steal a person's soul when you take their picture.
Spur gear looks pretty good. So we're right there. We're just gonna need some diff internals. Alright. So this is Chris LaBash.
Thanks for the burger.
Saw the
what are you doing here?
Saw it happen outside and showed you how
he's not thinking clearly.
How to figure out which differential it is. It's definitely our center. And, now these look okay.
Fuck you.
But turn down the movie on the side and back in the background. These look okay. When you're shimming, these guys up, all you want to do is you're gonna put your shims on the back side of this. So the object on here to make the tighter differential is to put two shims on one side, and you're gonna put one shim on the other side. So you have your two shims on this side of the planetary. We'll put that in. And you're gonna have one shim on this side of the other planetary. Okay. And then on the other one, you're gonna do the same thing. You want two on one side and two on the other side. So one, two shims onto the shaft, one shim onto the shaft on the other side, and that's it. Same thing with this one. You got two shims on one side. So there's one, two. And then you're gonna put your cap end slide back on. And on the other side of the shaft, you're gonna have one shim. So you're gonna put that behind your gear, put your gear on, and put your plant end back on. One, two. So it's one, two, one, one, two, one. And that'll tighten up the internals of your diff quite a bit. Like I said, these are the original parts. Now, I've had this truck for an extremely long time, and I have never bought any diff internals. Now, I might just buy all the pieces and just start with a new center, because I could have a spare differential built, and you don't want to lose your pins. I'll have to get extra crown gear, sun gear, outdrive gear, spare outdrive gear, so I might have to pick up, if I want a spare differential, I'll pick up four of these, and just a set of the planetaries. So that's how you take apart and shim your differential. Oh yeah, and your Mugen shims. These are all Mugen shims, I believe. On the inside, you're gonna have one shim here to hold the outdrive tighter. Your outdrive comes up. Put your bearing on always first. Can't stress that enough. And your outdrive comes up, and you want your shim to be right where you put the pin. The pin will be tighter held in, tightly held in, and you do the same on the ring gear side. Here's your Mugen shim there. It goes. Always check to make sure your gaskets are in place. Then comes with your Mugen shim, and then you put your outdrive through. We're going to be taking this one out because we need to clean out the diff, which was not empty, but not very full. So as you can see there, you got your gasket seal and your Mugen shim. And then this is this is how it looks stock. All right guys, so this is Chris LaBash. I'm just showing you how to shim up your diffs to make them, you know, bulletproof. The only shims that I believe I didn't show you are the Tekken shims. They are the shims that you will put on the outside ring gear that will push the ring gear into the pinion. That's gonna be on the drive cup. You'll have your bearing, and then you're going to have the two Tekken shims along with all the Mugen shims I showed you in the video. If you need part numbers to all these shims, feel free. I do have them. Feel free to ask. Or I will edit the description and we'll put them in there. And that's what you're going to do for all of your diffs. I didn't show you the Tekken shims because usually you're not going to use those on your center differential. You're going to use those on your front and rear, and the point is to put the shims in on the ring gear side to push that ring gear a little bit tighter into the pinion gear on the output shaft of the drive cup to the center differential. So that's where you're going to be putting the Tekken shims. They're bigger. They're about the size of your bearing on the output shafts. Output drive cups. They're about the size of that bearing, and they will just tighten up that ring and pinion for the differential. That's pretty much how you make the bulletproof 6S, Typhon, Outcast, Creighton, any 6S differential. I'm not so sure about the limited slip differentials. I'm sure there's a different way to shim those up. Yeah, that's how you make the bulletproof differential for the 6S line of vehicles. Alright guys, so that's about it. I appreciate and thank all of you for subscribing. Those who like these videos and haven't subscribed, please hit that subscribe button and smash the bell so we can get these numbers up and we can do some live feeds and we'll have some more chat, more input. Like I said, these are the original internals I have in all of these diffs in my Outcast, and this started out as a version 2 Outcast, so it's been, I've had it for a number of years now, and I've never changed any of the internals of the diff. I've actually never have spun a ring and pinion either. This is the first internal gears that I have. In the planetaries are fine, and the port gears are in decent shape. They're not terrible, but they are slipping a little bit, and that is due to probably running. I think I put 500,000 fluid in there, so over time, you know, it's gonna wear them down a little bit. 10 seconds, or I mean, couple of passes up and down the street, and flipped it over pretty good, and it was just enough to bend the pin in that 12 millimeter hex, and it spun that hex out. So tomorrow we'll be running the Traxxas Haas fully upgraded truck, and that's honestly one of the first upgrades you should do. But please just like, comment, and make sure you guys subscribe. All right, thank you. This is Chris Labash, and stay tuned, and we'll be running that soon. So, and the Outcast will be back out also very soon. Thanks guys, bye.